It looks as though, from my perspective, it's all about government spending here, federal, local. Why the focus there? What's going so well?
Well, federal is is a very rapidly growing business. I think our federal business, particularly in defense intelligence, grew greater than 100% year over year. State and local, this is about government services, is a huge adopter of enterprise AI, but so is manufacturing, financial services, petrochemicals, energy. So I'd say across the board, we're seeing very, very substantially increased demand in applying enterprise AI to business processes, to government processes, to defense, and to intelligence.
What's interesting, though, is, of course, we've had a bit of worry about corporate enterprise spending on software more generally coming from, well, the results of Salesforce today. What are you seeing in terms of enterprise? Because it does look as though the real beef of your growth is coming from federal and government. What is sentiment like for the oil and gas companies that you're working with, for the other broader sectors?
Oil and gas, utilities, government services, consumer packaged goods, agribusiness, we're seeing, you know, very significant growth and increased demand in enterprise AI. Now, understand, Caroline, you could think of C3.ai as really as the first native AI company. We started 15 years ago, mm-hmm. building an enterprise AI stack. This is before Google Cloud, before Azure, when AWS was this big, before the graphic GPU. So we started early. We spent billions building a software stack. Today we have 90 turnkey enterprise applications for supply chain, demand chain, fraud, whatever it might be. So think of C3.ai. We're in a little bit different class than these legacy enterprise application software people. This is the first enterprise AI, pure enterprise AI play.
Well, you know those legacy people well. You sold your previous business to Oracle. And I'm interested as to why, therefore, to be brutally honest, why your share price sort of hasn't been wrapped up in the exuberance of AI. If you are such a pure play, I'm looking at, well, it's still well off the highs of 2021. What do you think you're still having to prove to the market at the moment?
Well, I think that, you know, we're at the very early stages of this enterprise AI market. You know, we're seeing a lot of interest right now in silicon and infrastructure. If we look at the value of the stack, AI stack, at the bottom you have silicon. Above that, you have infrastructure. Above that, you have foundation models. And on top of that, you have the applications. Well, that's the level of the stack. That's the portion of the stack in which we play. Now, all of this silicon that, you know, that is NVIDIA is selling, and all this infrastructure that hyperscalers are selling, they're only selling it for one reason, building this capacity. It's to run enterprise AI applications. And Carolyn, that's what we do.
So let's get really detailed, Tom. Can you give us an anecdote of what a key company in manufacturing is using your technology to achieve?
The United States Air Force is using it for predictive maintenance for, today, 22 weapon systems, F-15, F-16, F-18, F-35, et cetera. Okay, and by using predictive analytics, predictive maintenance, we can prevent unplanned system outage and increase aircraft availability on any given day by 25%. Predictive maintenance at Dow here in, you know, steam cracking units associated with polyethylene production. Okay, we can reduce unplanned downtime by 20%. Hey, that's worth hundreds of millions of years to Dow. So these are you know, two very real applications with, you know, substantial economic return. Mm-hmm. I would say the application that I cited at the United States Air Force might be the largest enterprise application on Earth. Shell is realizing, you know, $2 billion in economic benefit a year from what they call Shell AI, which is C3.ai combined with Azure. So yeah. The returns are substantial. This is no drill. This is not hype. This is very real.
Well, is the risk very real? We hype up the efficiencies of AI. We hype up the market valuations. We also sometimes in the media like to hype up the risks. What do you take to the risks and regulatory respect to that?
The risks associated with AI are daunting, and I would be afraid. We need to be very concerned about personal privacy. I believe that, you know, personal privacy is a fundamental human right, okay? And AI threatens that. We will, you know, so I think privacy issues will these, you know, we're seeing, you know, social media, the AI and social media being used to, you know, it's a public health hazard. Think about, you know, depression, suicide, body image issues in young women. These technologies are being used to interfere in democratic processes. So, you know, the risks associated with AI are very real, and we need to be very concerned, and we need to plan for them, and we need to avoid them.